morning, afternoon, or evening, and welcome back to Edenia. Today we're playing some more Sky Factory 3. Now, as you might know, I've been playing this this map for a while, and we yet have to touch any farming. We haven't done any farming yet, so we need a lot of dirt to do that. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to farm some trees, get some stuff done. There we go, like this. Let's plant some new ones. I'm just going to create some dirt until we have enough to build a nice little platform, because otherwise we're just not being efficient enough with our farms if we just do small things, small little patches like we did before. Not saying that it can't be effective with small patches. For instance, we have a couple of small farming patches over here. I'll show you. For instance, our rice field. We don't need a lot of rice, or as it says, cheese and paper cones. And this is going to be string, and this is going to be coffee beans. Oh, this is the only one that actually says coffee beans. This is flax. This is canola, but it says paper cones. And I'm not saying that we need big, giant fields of these. But for the farming we've got planned, we need a lot of space. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to convert everything we get to dirt via this machine. It's not very efficient, but you know, it will give us the stuff we need. So I'm just gonna sit here and farm a lot of trees, and I'll be back later. While we wait for everything to convert to dirt, because it is a rather slow machine, you might want multiples of these barrels and multiple transfer nodes to speed things up a bit. Well, we're kind of strapped for resources. In the meantime, speaking of resources, someone told me that I can make a juicer, and it's a very easy recipe. You just do something like this, you get a juicer, and if you put your apples in the juicer, they become better because they have more saturation, which is really good to have a bit of saturation. I'm gonna keep this with me for every for new apples that I get. It's really good to have these juices, because it really makes food less of a hassle. We are going to need some apples though, because what I'm planning on needs a lot more of these apples. For now, this will do nicely. Let's see, these are growing nice, but not too good yet, not too well. What we're going to do is, we are so strapped for resources, we need to do a bit of sifting as well, just to get the resources we need. For instance, we need a bit of redstone so we can expand on this, make more transfer nodes, etc, etc. So we need to transform everything into dust. This is going to take a while, but that's good, because this is going to take a while too. So yeah, we're not doing a lot on camera, it seems, this episode, but you know, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a big bunch of compressed cobblestone, and I'm going to just going to convert it into dust to get some I'm saying dust because I need redstone, but I also need a lot of diamonds to finish the diamond sieve setup, because we're not going to do automatic sieves in this playthrough. No, we're going to go right into mystical farming, because it's mystical agriculture, because it's just that good. It's a bit of a shame to not do mystical agriculture. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a bit more grinding. I'll see you later. As you can clearly see, I'm sifting a stack of dust now. The redstone always ends up later. As you can see, it takes a while for the redstone to arrive. And that's simply because of this bug, that whenever you sift dust, redstone just goes flying everywhere. The ring of magnetization is really a solution to this. You could also make this a confined space. So if you put a ceiling on this room and some walls, not just fences, but actual walls, you'll get most of it, I bet. So there we go, that's done. Let's see, we got 25 redstone from 9 stacks of dust. That's not really great. That is not the best. Alright, we'll just have to live with it. Also, with all the gunpowder we're getting, I was kind of looking at explosive generators. Look at that. explosive generators. They take gunpowder or TNT to run, and they're really good as well. They produce 80 RF per tick, just like these magmatic engines. I believe these do... I can't really see what they do at the moment because they're not doing anything. I would have believed they did 80 RF per tick. So, might be worth looking into the explosive generators. I'm guessing, though, they're going to make a lot of noise. And I'm also guessing they're going to hurt. So, we need to plant those somewhere safe. All right. Oh, we can't make coffee... actual coffee seeds from this. Oh, all right, that's a bit of a bummer. I do believe we can do the canola. Yeah, there we go. A canola would be a really interesting power source as well, because I've never used it before. We might want to look into that. Anyway, that's the farming for now. What I'm really eager to do is to actually get some stuff done. And the only way to actually get some stuff done in this mod pack is if you have a lot of items to sift. Because that's where it all starts, right? You need your resources, you need your metals. So we might want to look into having a sag mill or two. There we go, sag mill. Now these are not very hard to make. Just take a bit of iron, a basic capacitor, which does take a bit of redstone for every machine. But that's fine. We need 3 redstone at least for every sag mill, and we need at least 2 sag mills. Sag mills will help us convert stone into gravel and gravel into sand, and then we can use an auto hammer to convert the sand into dust. So we always have a couple of stacks of everything. So if we need to sift something, we don't need to hammer it manually to get it, because that's the real pain in the bum. So what we're going to do is we're going to create one of these sack mills and see how efficient it will be. Just takes a couple of iron, a couple of flint. Yeah, we got this. Flint. Do I have any flint? That's a good question to start with. Doesn't look like it. I cannot see flint. If I have it, I cannot see it. So, well, we're going to have to sift a bit of gravel through a normal string mesh then. The normal string mesh will actually give us gravel we need. Sorry, it will give us the flint we need from the gravel. You can also craft the actual gravel, but it's the actual flint from gravel, but it's at a bit of a loss. So I'm just going to sift because we need materials anyway. So there we go, once again. And there we go. That's a lot of gravel done like that. That was also 9 stacks, got us a nice bit of gravel, also a couple of metals. It will always give you metals if you sift, so that's really good to have. We don't need any of these in particular right now, but we'll keep them, just because. Let's see, let's put this away. The flint, I keep saying gravel, but it's flint, obviously. We need a couple of these. I don't believe we don't, and we need that much. A bit of iron, a bit of redstone. We also need some stone and some wood. We don't have a lot of wood because I've been hitting trees to get the pulp instead. So why don't we do something like this, and then something like this. That only gave us 2 saplings. Because we were not using a crook. That's harsh, man. That's very harsh. All right, wood for the old pistons. We're going to need a stack of cobble. There we go. All right, so that's that. We also need some copper. Do we have any more copper? Yes, we have. We also need a couple of these nuggets. Redstone we already have. Great. Alright, let's make some sack mills. First of all, some of these would be nice. We need 2 sack mills at the bare minimum to get us anywhere efficient. We need some iron bars. Do we have some? We have. Great. We need 8 for 2 of these machine frames. There we go. We also need 2 pistons. And then I do believe that we can just make these 2 sack mills. Great. Now, We might want to hang on to some redstone because we're going to need to make a flux point. Where is it? The flux point receives energy. So that's a block of redstone and four of these flux cores, which is four redstone, four obsidian, and an ender eye. So block of redstone, that's going to be 9 plus 4. Great. We don't need any iron. I believe that's it. Yep. All right, so let's get rid of the wood. Get rid of the cobblestone. We'll just chuck it off the edge. There we go. One ender eye, we can do that. It's easy. We've got pearls. There we go, an eye of ender. We do have a bit of redstone. We need to convert this one into a block. And we need to burn four of these redstones in here. That's fine. We might want to grab two saplings to make sure that everything of these burns. Alright, now watch this. I'm about to go eat, or drink rather, some apple juice. And instead of just giving a very tiny bit of saturation, this will keep me saturated for quite a while. So that's really good to have. Two saplings, yeah, that would make this perfect. We need four obsidian, so let's grab those. And that would create our flux point. Great stuff. You know, I really love mods like this, where you can just do wireless energy. Great stuff. Alright, a flux point. Do we want this sack mill operation to be somewhere near the sifters? That would be great, wouldn't it? Yeah. Alright, how are we going to do this? We might want to have an extra opening in here and just have it right next to. Yeah, I think that would be great. Let's grab some torches. Because we need to light this up, right? But we need to have fence gates in here, so we need one more torch. One more. So let's not put the torch there, but let's put the torch there. Right, this will be another entrance. Do we really need these fence gates? I don't really think so anymore. Nah, this will be fine. We'll just walk through. That's fine. So, yeah, this can go back. Great. So we've got a flux point, we've got a sag mills, we've got an oak fence that we really don't need to have on us right now. We do need some cobblestone to make the platform a bit bigger, and I'll just set up the sag mills really fast. So yeah, I'll be back in a minute. So let's do this. Let's make this machine, right? One sag mill, two sag mills, that would be great. We also want the auto hammer. Put it right underneath. That's at a bit of a weird angle. Can we put it like this? No, it will stay at that angle. All right. We can't really see the hammer then. It's just a line. But that's fine. We need to get some energy conduits up in here. And we also need to put the flux point on here. Let's put the flux point. I really want to get it on top. There we go. Nice. Select a network. We'll select our own network because that's the network we're using. Now this is getting energy. That's great. This is getting energy and this is already full. So this is consuming 20 RF per tick. This is also consuming 20 RF. All right. These will all do 20 RF per tick. So our system should be able to handle it nicely. So what will this do? Need a hopper of some description. We'll use a hopper because it will not use any redstone. We could make some item conduits, really. Item conduit. But that will need pulsating iron nuggets, which will need molten pulsating iron. We can do that. We can do molten iron and liquefied ender pearls. Alright, we'll do it. Let's turn this off. Do we have some iron still in our sieving backpack? That would be great. We do, lots. Amazing. All right, so let's put this in. And we'll make a couple of ender pearls into liquid. Four. I think four will do nicely. There we go. I also hear an enderman somewhere. Oh, he's over there. All right. Let's look at him. Where is he? There he is. He's gone. It's a bit of a... Oh, there we go. I'm so very glad that we've got these trees. There we go, and a free new enderpearl. That's great. Alright. You can stop screaming now. Thanks. Alright, so pulsating iron will mean that we can make some item conduits, which is going to be great. This is going to empty really soon, and we'll have some pulsating iron in here, so that's going to be great. Let's wait for that on a moment. So we get 4 ingots of pulsating iron, which is not bad, because we only need the nuggets for the item conduits, and it will give us 8, so that's really good. 2 pulsating iron will do for now. Let's turn these into nuggets. Let's grab some conduit binders, and let's make some of these, because we're going to be using them. There we go. Let's put these ones back. And the rest of the iron will just be pulled out. That's fine. Alright, so we've got item conduits. Let's make a bit of a staircase. There we go. Let's put this one here. And let's put the cobblestone gen on top. How am I going to do this? Just like that. Great. So, this is going to be extract always active, and this is going to be insert. There we go. So this one will now get cobblestone as quick as it can, which is great, and this will produce gravel. Now, what are we going to do with the gravel? We're going to have the gravel go down into our sand machine. The sand machine will have to push it down into our dust machine. There we go. And this will now get sand in it and produce dust. Now this inventory will fill up with dust. And this is... because dust is probably going to be the one we need the most. Because of redstone. So that's really really nice that it has a really big inventory for dust. So we can just go in here, grab some dust, get out. The flint. Yeah, you know what we're going to do with the flint? We're also going to say push up. We're also going to say push up. So that whenever it has flint in it, it will try to push it up. So what if we make this push and pull? Yeah, great. And... oh, none. There we go. And this should also be push and pull. There we go. Because this is full of cobblestone, this will never accept any sand. This will also produce a bit of sand. Every now and again. It will also store the flint in here. That's really great, because the flint will make sure that what is it? There's a main output bonus of 120%. And it will also, it will also give us bonus output. And power reduction. So that's really great. So there we go. Sand is going in here. That's fine. This is getting filled. We need to funnel off this sand somehow. We're going to need some item conduits then. Alright. So this is going to be extract always active. And this is going to be extract always active. And this is going to be insert. There we go. So if there is any sand stuck somewhere, it will take it out. Also, the flint's now all going in here. This one doesn't have any flint. I don't think that's really what we want. You know, let's disable this. This as well. Disabled. And let's disable this as well. There we go. Now all items should stay in. what we're going to do is we're going to make each of these insert and extract. And we'll have to configure them in and out. And this will just be in because we don't need any flint in here. I need some item filters. Basic item filters, which is just a hopper and some paper. And we can have two of those, I do believe. So this will take the gravel, this will take the sand. For now it's going all... Yeah, you know, I don't think we need any filters at all. This will do fine. It will try to find a place for it. And as long as it has, anything in it, it will do fine. So this one has flint now, this will produce sand. Yep, this will produce sand, this will produce dust. Now, this is a slow machine, so you might want more of these, actually. Yeah, it wouldn't be bad to have more of these, actually. That would be great, actually. I say actually a lot, actually. So, what's this? Chiseled stone road? Oh, I believe we have lost some textures. Alright, let me restart the game for a second then. I'm also going to make some drawers, because these drawers are really great to have. You can store a lot of items in it, and that's it's basically like the better barrels from earlier mod packs. But the better barrels are not in these mod packs, so we'll have to do with these drawers, which is fine, because they're great. Let's see, there we go. Let's get rid of this for a second because we need a bit more wood to get us started. There we go. Get you out as well. You can go in here. Still creating dirt. That's going to take forever. Alright, so we have a couple of drawers. We need at least four, I guess. Yeah, at least four. Because we have flint, dust, gravel and sand. So we need four of these drawers. Upgrade templates. We're going to need a couple more upgrade templates. So we need to make more drawers even still. Because we need to... well, we don't really need to upgrade them. We just need to lock them. You know what? We're going to keep the upgrades for now. We can always void upgrade them later. Because void upgrading is the smart thing to do. How are we going to do this? You know, that's three of them, but we need four. And we might need the controller. That's a bit drawer. We need a normal drawer controller. Which, of course, takes a diamond. We only have one diamond left. Alright, so what if we expand on this just a little bit? Make the wall a bit bigger. And just put the drawers in front of them. I think that would be a nice solution to this problem we're having. Alright, so we need to lock these drawers first. Put the relevant item in it. For instance, one gravel. This will be gravel. And this will be sand. This will be dust, and we just need one for flint as well. There we go. These are all locked, and now we can all set these to insert with low priority. So insert low priority, insert low priority, and insert low priority. There we go. And the reason we're using low priority is because we want the items to go into the respective machine first, before they get pushed in here. So there we go. This one now has 8 gravel. We've got just over a stack of sand. We've got less than a stack of dust. I don't believe this is outputting, because I haven't set this to output. There we go. This should be in and out. There we go. Always active on the extract. Is this always active on the extract? Yes. And is this always active on the extract? Yes. Great. So now, yeah, we got rid of the dust. There we go. We got just over a stack, and we've got 12 gravel. Got a bit of flint as well. Great. So these will try to put the flint in themselves if they can, which is great. So they are a bit more efficient, and we're getting dust. You know, this is fully automated. It's not the best system I've ever done, but you know, it's quick and efficient. That's all that really matters, is it? So yeah, if we ever need something, we can just grab it from here and we'll sift it right away. So that's really good. Really good to have. For now, the upgrade template can go in here. That's fine. We can put away the key. You know what? Keep the key on yours, on my person. There we go. Item conduits. Yeah, that's all stuff we might want to keep on our person as well. Item conduits and energy conduits. That's fine. Our Ender Lily is doing really great. Not that it really matters, because... well, we're not getting Ender Pearls, actually. We are wasting Ender Pearls. We do have a couple of loot bags. There we go. And we also have a chance cube, and someone told me to open up the chance cube. I might open up the chance cube. So, let's see what I can get from these loot bags. These are the basic loot bags. They do have a lot of interesting items that we can use. For instance, these prismarine crystals and shards, we might need those in the future. So let's open up. A couple of items, there we go. We can just shift right click onto these and see what we got later on. So that's fine. That's all good. There we go. Let's open them up. We don't want the legendaries just yet. This is fine. There we go. So what did we all get? We got a couple of sponges. Inferium essence. We already had some bricks. Melon seeds. Raw chicken. Raw salmon. Wheat. Carrots. Blaze powder. Electrical. Oh, we need this electrical steel. That's a godsend. That's great. Chance cubes. Hen houses. Will automatically collect items from chickens in a 9x9x9 area radius when provided with hay bale. Alright, that's interesting. But it takes hay bales. You know, when something takes items to run, you might as well just use a vacuum hopper like we did just now. A shaver? That's interesting. A jerkinator. Right. Accepted food. Beef jerky, beef Wellington. I don't know what this does. Is it some kind of auto feeder? It might be an auto feeder. We've got some lily pads. That's snowballs. Purple slime saplings. How to use the dirt chest. An iron ingot. A portal charm. Don't know what it does. There's also a baconator. A redstone torch. You know, anything that saves me from using a redstone is a good treasure in my book. Let's put the cake down. We've got a new iron wand, which is great. Yeah, nothing too interesting, really. A storage upgrade. 3x base value. That can be useful. Some packing tape. Well, that's all the treasures, then. Also, yeah, the chance cubes. Ouch. Oh, that's the Ender Lily. Right. Also, the chance cubes, we might want to open up the chance cubes on a different island. Because the chance cubes are known to wreck your world. And I don't mean in the good sense. No, really, it's in the bad sense. It will wreck your world. It will destroy everything you've built. Worst case scenario. We do have the electrical steel. We need to make a Yetta wrench. There we go. We need a basic gear, which is the sticks and stones. My stone. I just threw my stone off the cliff, of course. Four of these, and let's go down. Four of these. That will create my basic gear. Together with three electrical steel is a Yetta wrench. Look at that. We've got a Yetta wrench. This is a really handy item. If you right click on a conduit, it will Sorry, if you right click on a conduit end, it will try to get rid of it, and also put it back if you want to. We don't need this in and out, we just need this in. insert with priority minus one. You can also shift left click, I believe. No, doesn't seem to work like that. I thought that would give you the option to... Oh yeah, there it is. If you shift left click, it will go into the UI, so you can choose what kind of item you want to configure, and that will give you the configuration. So that's really good as well. And shift right clicking will remove conduits altogether, so that's also really good. This is holding up nicely. We're automatically producing all the items we need to sift. It does take a while, but we can speed this up if we want to. We can put some more diamond hammers in here, so that's good. We can also put some capacitors in here. Capacitor, let's take a look. So this is the double layer one, which needs energetic alloys. We don't have that. We don't have vibrant alloys as well. We do have redstone and copper to make the normal capacitor. So let's make some basic capacitors just so these machines can run a bit faster. It will take 4 redstone, 2 copper, and some nuggets as well. That's it, right? Yeah, that's it. There we go. 2 basic capacitors. And if you put these in the machines, they will run faster. Oh, it doesn't seem to work with the basic capacitors. Oh well, we've made some basic capacitors then for later. I wonder what kind of item goes in here then. I thought they were a capacitor. Oh, you actually need the double layered capacitor to make it a machine upgrade. So what's the energetic alloy? What does it take? It takes redstone, gold, and glow gas. Oh, glowstone, of course. So redstone, gold, and glowstone. We might be able to make some, actually. Because we have all these items, just not a lot of it, but we have all the items. So let's do it like this. Let's put them in. Yeah, it does seem to be working, so we'll have some alloys. And there we go, 2 molten energetic alloys. Great stuff. Let's grab these. I believe we need 2 just to make 1 of these. Yeah, and some coal powder. Crushed coal. Alright, we don't have any coal. Can it also use charcoal? No, of course not. That would be too easy. Coal sand, coal powder, crushed coal. Let's see. Oh, it will get coal powder from other things as well. It has a chance of doing. Let's see. Charcoal is not an option, of course. Right. So coal powder, crushed coal. That goes into a crusher, of course. We don't have a crusher. And crushed sand. Coal sand is coal in a crusher to make coal sand. Right, so it looks like we need actual coal, which we don't have. So we need to sift some gravel. But that's all future music, because we are running out of time on this episode. We're overdue. So thank you very much for watching. If you did like this episode, you're free to leave a like. And if you didn't, you're free to leave a dislike, which doesn't help the channel, but at least you're being honest on the internet. So thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you all next time. Have a great day.